Today we're going to walk you through a motor startup with an F6 drive. Before we get to the programming, let's go through our hardware checklist. First, we have our drive and motor. You'll need to make sure you have an AC supply to the drive and your motor power cable. Sometimes you'll need an encoder cable or brake wiring, and then you'll also need low voltage wiring. This includes the STO or safe torque off to the drive, which is the enable. For connecting to the drive for programming, the easiest solution is to use our USB to serial converter. If necessary, other options are available, but this is the simplest way to do it. If you do have a keypad like this, you can connect to the drive directly with it using a USB cable. Otherwise, you can use the USB to serial converter with the same standard USB cable and connect directly to the front of the drive. Now that we've checked all of our hardware and made our connections to the PC, we can power up the drive and move to the programming side. When you open up the COMBIVIS software, you'll see this for your start page. You can start a new project, open an existing project, but we'll start with a device scan. This automatically searches through your PC ports connections and should find the drive right away. We'll do start search, and you can see the F6 drive pop up. So we'll go add selected devices, and then you can see it added to the project here. The green plug means you're online. You can adjust the communication settings, step through the wizards like we will. This is all of the drive parameters you can see, and then also the operator parameters. So within the wizards, we'll step through here, and then in a matter of minutes, we'll have the motor spinning. So to start with, we'll reset device to defaults. This just defaults the drive to its factory settings, just to make sure that there's no odd programming that's left in there from the previous time. Now typically this takes a few seconds, so we'll just wait a minute. And then now the drive is defaulted and you can see we're still connected again. So to start with is the motor setup. If you're using a KEB motor, you can plug in the part number up top. Otherwise, you can just enter the basic nameplate data, which we will do here. And again, with the F6 drive, you can run an induction motor, asynchronous, or you can also run a synchronous motor, a servo motor, with the exact same drive. In this case, we have no temperature sensor, but it supports a number of different options you can see here. This is if you're using a braking resistor, which you're not in this case, and also brake control. The drive has a 24-volt brake control that can be used to open and close the motor brake. This motor does not have one, so we don't have to worry about it. And again, no sign filter for this motor. This error state occurred because we turned the motor temperature sensor off, so this will just quickly reset the error. And now we have a couple of different control types. Volts per hertz mode, which is the most basic open loop. Encoder with motor model. As it sounds, it's with an encoder. Or encoder list. This is what we use here, so it's a closed loop control but does not need the encoder to work. The system inversion allows you to swap directions of the motor without changing any wiring. So if forward is clockwise but you're expecting to be counterclockwise, you can swap that direction here. And if we had an encoder, you can set that up here. The speed controller of the F6 drive is a PI or proportional and integral controller. You can adjust those two terms here, or they're grouped together down here with this controller performance. We'll also enter the motor inertia value up here, and if you have a load inertia, you can enter it here as well. The position controller is just a proportional controller, but can be adjusted here. The next tab is the protections and warnings. The drive has a whole bunch of different functions built in to protect itself, the motor, or the machine as a whole throughout the operation. We don't have to adjust any of those here, but they're just something to keep in mind that all these functions are built in and available if need be. So the next step is the motor identification. This is required if you're doing the sensorless control. So this is the same motor data that was entered in the previous tab. The main inductance means the motor will spin during this operation. This will move to 65% of the rated speed. If necessary, you can do without the inductance detection, and it will be static, but it won't be as accurate. And then you can see the status of the drive, so we'll have to set the STO, the brake control bit we don't have to worry about, and then we can do start identification. This operation typically takes a minute or two, and you can expect to hear high-pitched frequency noises coming from the motor during the operation. During this process, the motor is pushing current through the motor at various frequencies to measure the resistance, inductance, and so on. This allows the drive to create an electronic equivalent to the motor within its programming. Now that the identification is complete, we can confirm the measured values and move on. The next step is the mode of operation. The drive has a number of different control modes available. There's a standard velocity mode, positioning mode, or cyclic synchronous modes for more advanced operation. For this, we'll just use the velocity mode. You can use an S-curve or linear speed ramps. You can enter your min and max speeds for both directions here. And then especially helpful is the curve settings. With this, you can see exactly what your speed ramp looks like. So if we go to full speed in both directions, you can see what it looks like to have different ramp times for each, or you can simply match your forward acceleration for all of them for a simple setup. The F6 drive supports a number of different Fieldbus options. EtherCAT is standard, but Ethernet IP, Profinet, Modbus TCP are also available. In this case, we're just using the COMBIVIS software to control the drive, so we don't have to worry about the EtherCAT setup. And that's all there is to the setup. Now we can go into the test run wizard and spin the motor. So with this, you can see the state machine of the drive that's affected by the control words, and you can see the status word coming back. You can enter a number of different speed set points, and you can start and stop the motor. With this, you can also get a scope set up. The scope allows you to trace up to 16 parameters within the drive, so you can easily see what's going on during the operation. And also at any time, if you drag and drop any of these windows, you can customize your viewing screen. So now we'll enter a couple of different speed values here, and you can see how it's reflected in the scope. All you have to do is hit start, and the motor ramps up. And with these, you can easily toggle between, again, three different speed set points. Now the F6 has a whole bunch more functions built in. This is barely scratching the surface, but with the startup wizards, you can easily step through and get your motor spinning in a matter of minutes. If you have questions, feel free to contact us at kebamerica.com.